Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar, and today we are going to talk about why you should not stop eating wheat or foods having gluten for bodybuilding or fitness purposes or for a general layman, why you should not stop eating wheat or any other gluten related food. See, you might have come across this by now that a lot of people would say, oh, for losing fat you have to stop eating chapati, roti, what we call phalke in Hindi, in Rajasthan. You have to stop eating wheat because wheat has gluten. If you eat gluten, gluten would stick to your intestinal walls and it would hamper the absorption of vitamins and minerals. If you eat wheat, it will lead to fat gain. If you eat rice, it will lead to fat gain. You might have come across all of these things if you are into bodybuilding or fitness, or maybe if you are a general layman. See, if you have any sort of gluten related problems diagnosed, then you can go for gluten free foods. I have talked about who should stop eating gluten and when. I have made this video one or two videos before this video. You can go check that video out to see if you need to stop eating gluten or not. Most probably you don't need to stop eating gluten, but watch that video. I will highly recommend it. Okay, so let's say you watched that video and you came to realize that you do not need to stop eating gluten rich foods. So if you do not need to stop eating gluten and you stop eating gluten, then what can be harmful effects? That is what we are going to discuss in this video. If this video is of big length, I would recommend that you watch it completely and especially share it with people. But let's discuss it now. So if you stop eating gluten, see, science says that gluten is good for your gut bacteria, good gut bacteria. I've talked about gut bacteria in my previous video. So it is good for your for the growth of your good gut bacteria, which improves your health. And if you stop eating gluten, it can be harmful for the health of good gut bacteria, and it can increase bad bacteria in your gut, in your intestines, which can have negative impact on your health. So basically, if you stop eating gluten, you are taking your health in a negative direction. Okay, so let's say you had no problems with gluten, you have been born and brought up eating gluten rich foods, you have been born and brought up eating chapatis, wheat, barley, and you all of a sudden decide to that okay, for abs you need to stop eating wheat and rice, and you stopped eating wheat for a lot of months, and you kept that practice for a lot of years because you were into fitness industry, and you stop. So what would happen is, when you do that for a long significant period of time, then you might become gluten intolerant. So basically, if you stopped eating gluten, after a long period of time, you might not be able to digest gluten, and then it becomes a disease where when you eat gluten, it creates problems for you. So in a holistic perspective, you had no disease. All of a sudden you saw something on the internet, okay, gluten free is healthy, okay, and you stopped eating gluten all of a sudden, and you got a disease for free, and you got a disease for free just because you saw misleading information in bodybuilding or fitness industry. You got a disease and you impacted your health in a negative way. So you perhaps not want to get a disease for free, also impacting your health in a negative way. Now, this disease, if you catch this disease, it is a genetic disease. So if you catch this disease by stopping to eat gluten, then it is likely that your children or your grandchildren will also suffer from the disease. They can also suffer from the disease. So basically, you did the mistake and your children or grandchildren or their children might suffer because of your mistake, because of your little knowledge. You did not research about anything, you just stopped eating gluten. So basically, you do not want your upcoming generations to be suffering from something without any reason. Maybe you won't eat it again in your life, but your children or grandchildren might not know this, and they might eat it, they might like it, and then they can be facing issues. Now, our ancestors ate this staple food for ages. See, first of all, let me tell you that according to Ayurveda, something which is grown in a particular environment should be eaten in that particular environment. So basically, if I am living in Rajasthan, I should be eating things that are grown in Rajasthan, because those things were grown in the environment of Rajasthan, and my body is currently in the environment of Rajasthan, so those things would suit my body. So basically, if in Rajasthan we eat bajra because it is grown in Rajasthan, then we should eat more bajra and less of rice, because rice is grown in southern India, and South Indians should be eating more rice and less of bajra, because bajra is not grown in southern India. So basically, as per Ayurveda, you should be eating the food that is grown in your environment. So I'll talk about North India in this case. So for North Indians, the states like Haryana and Rajasthan and many other states, and many states in the central India, this wheat chapati has been a staple food for hundreds or maybe thousands of years. So in the morning you would have your sabji and chapati and dal, and in the evening you would have your sabji and chapati and dal or kadhi. So the chapati, the wheat chapati, has been a staple food for really long time, proving that it is a healthy food and can be eaten for your whole life. Our ancestors have eaten it for their whole lives, and they have lived for more than 100 years eating wheat almost every day. This proves that it is a healthy food and it can be eaten on regular basis every day for the whole life, not reducing your lifespan. Okay, now why our ancestors chose only this as a staple food in North Indian regions? See, at that time science was not so developed, so definitely science did not tell them anything. Most probably science did not tell them anything. But Ayurveda was present around, Ayurveda has been around for thousands of years. So even thousands of years back, our ancestors might have come to know that wheat is good for our regular health. We can eat it daily for our whole lives from Ayurveda. But today we general people lack knowledge of Ayurveda, and there are not so many people with really deep knowledge of Ayurveda. It is hard to find people with deep knowledge of Ayurveda nowadays. So there are not many people to tell us about what Ayurveda has to say about it. But back to the time of our ancestors, really thousands of years back, there were people with deep knowledge of Ayurveda, and they might have told our ancestors to keep this as a staple food. So that could be a reason that our ancestors chose it to be in our staple food, and the decision was right. They lived for over 100 years and they lived a healthy life eating it on a daily basis, and they have proved it for hundreds of years. Okay, so basically, when we have a path that is already proven to be a good path to walk on by our ancestors, why would we want to do experiment with our lives? why would we want to see an Instagram picture and see, okay, you should go gluten free, okay, I'll buy gluten free products because they'll help build abs, they'll help me with fat loss. Why, with your little knowledge, would you want to experiment on your body when you have just got one life, and you want to experiment with it? Why would you want to create a random new path for yourself, or a path that is not proven to be right? The path that our ancestors have shown us is proven to be right because they have walked upon that path for hundreds of years and lived a healthy, long life. So why would you want to experiment with your life? Don't experiment with your life. Walk on a path that has already been proven to be right. So basically, life is not for experimenting, because you have one life and life is short for experimenting. It is better that you learn from experience of others. Now, the last point that I would want to emphasize is, see, the food that you eat and the environment that you live in has an impact on your genetics. So if I'm living in Rajasthan, my ancestors in Rajasthan lived in the environment of Rajasthan and they ate some sort of specific foods, because of which over a period of hundreds or thousands of years, their genetics developed in a way that I got my genetics the way they are from them. So my genetics today are a result of what they were eating. My genetics today have a contribution of what they were eating and the environment they were living in. So basically, food and environment impacts your genetics. Okay. So what they did for thousands of years has an impact on my genetics today. Now, with your little knowledge, you start eating random foods, like sipping on green tea 3 times a day. With your little knowledge, you start doing random things and you stopped eating wheat chapati just by, because you saw on internet or you read somewhere that, oh, gluten can be bad for you. So you with your little knowledge, without verifying your knowledge, you changed your food habit. Now when you change your food habit, you're kind of giving different information to your DNA, your genetics. You have changed your food habits. Now when you have your child, from his childhood would see your new food habits, and he would perhaps not even get to eat wheat chapati on a regular basis, and his child would perhaps not even get to know that wheat chapati has been a daily staple food of my ancestors. So what you're doing is you're kind of changing the food habit of a generation, your food habit, your child's child and his child. You're changing the food habit of a whole generation just because of your little knowledge, little unverified knowledge, unproven knowledge. You're changing food habit of a whole generation. And when you're changing the food habit of the old generation, you're simultaneously changing the genetics of the generation, genetics of the upcoming generations. And if the chosen food habits by you, the food habits that you chose, if those prove out to be wrong food habits, then you might be changing the genetics of the upcoming generations in a bad way. So basically, your decisions are going to be impacting your upcoming generations, and they can be impacting them in a bad way by impacting their genetics. So you might not want to harm your upcoming generations. So basically, don't take decisions on your little knowledge. Try to gain knowledge. Maybe you want to consult the knowledgeable guys, the doctors, before taking such harsh decisions on your diet. Maybe you want to watch my videos. I'm not self-praising, but I rather prefer to guide people in a right way. See, if you say that, oh, I want abs, my trainer told me that you should stop eating wheat, chapati and rice to gain abs, I'll not listen to you. You are talking rubbish. Maybe you want to think that way. But see, if you don't care for yourself, care for your family and friends, care for your mother, sister, father, brother and your children, care for your family and friends. Share it with them, and especially with those who are caught up by the myths in the fitness industry, the ones who have stopped eating wheat and rice thinking that it will lead to fat gain or it will hamper their muscle gain. Share it with people, share it with a lot of people. I think it is worth spreading. If you liked what I talked about in this video, share it with people. And I would also recommend that you watch all the videos in this series of mine of wheat and gluten. In every video I have talked about some specific things in detail, and it is hard to capture everything in one video, so I would strongly recommend that you watch all my videos in this series. Before this video, I think I have 5 or 6 videos before this video. I strongly recommend that you watch all these videos in this series. And if you think that I do not have time to watch 7, 8, 10 minutes, 12 minutes, 15 minutes, 17 minutes videos, then I would say, then giving your time to a 17 minute video is better than giving your time for 1 hour queue in a doctor's clinic, and then visiting the doctor multiple times, spending on medication, then visiting multiple doctors and not being able to diagnose your disease. So basically, you might want to spend 1 or 1.5 hours watching the whole series rather than spending that time in just one queue for your one doctor visit. And you can have multiple such doctors visit, or maybe hospitals visit, or maybe your medication and test report visit. So you do not want to be wasting time on medication, rather you would want to save yourself from medication as well as suffering. If you like the video, please like, comment and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.